watch the latest from India Science, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press on the bell icon to get notifications on all the science-related videos.
Hello, I'm Harsha Sharma and welcome to today's COVID Bulletin. Festivals are all about gathering and meeting family and friends. The upcoming festival season, therefore, may lead to a surge in COVID-19 cases in India. Recently, PM Modi has cautioned the people of COVID-19 spread ahead of the festivals. In his address to the nation, PM Modi said that the people have to continue to adhere to the COVID-appropriate behavior and norms until the vaccine comes. In the view of this, Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister of Science and Technology, Health and Family Welfare and Earth Sciences, shared a meeting with heads and directors of autonomous institutions of DST and CSIR on COVID-appropriate behavior. In this meeting, Dr. Harshvardhan cautioned people against complacence, carelessness and casual attitude towards combating COVID-19. He stated that the next 2.5 months are going to be very crucial for us in a fight against corona because of the winter season and the festival season. It becomes the responsibility of every citizen to not let our guard down and follow COVID-appropriate behavior to curb the spread of this infection. Urging the people across the country to follow the clarion call of the Prime Minister as a part of the Jan Andolan launched on the 8th of this month, the minister appealed the people to follow COVID-appropriate behavior. He said that the virus has adversely affected the whole world, but simple precautionary measures are effective in preventing the coronavirus to a large extent. Wearing mask, face cover, especially in public places, and following hand and respiratory etiquettes are the cardinal principles of the social vaccine. He stressed on the importance of physical distancing for effective containment of the disease. Dr. Harshvardhan asked all the head of the institutions to be front runners in showcasing the importance of the social vaccine to break the chain of the transmission of the disease in the country. PPE kits are an essential armor to safeguard the corona warriors against infection. However, the use of PPE kits has raised an important issue of its safe disposal. Now, scientists from CSIR, National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, have suggested on-site incineration as a way of safe disposal of PPE kits. CSIR NIRI scientists compared three end-of-life disposal methods: centralized incineration, decentralized incineration, and landfills. Based on their study, scientists concluded that the decentralized method or on-site incineration of PPE waste will reduce multiple contact points who handle the infected PPE kits and therefore will ensure less spread of the infection. The scientist also studied the PPE kit disposal methods from a sustainability viewpoint. In the study, scientists studied two disposal scenarios named landfill and incineration in both centralized and decentralized settings for 6 environmental impact categories, covering overall impacts on both terrestrial and marine ecosystems. As per the study, on-site incineration will not only prevent the spread of the infection, but will also reduce transportation cost and carbon dioxide release due to transport. The study has been published in an international peer-reviewed journal, Environment, Development and Sustainability. You would have often heard that the mortality due to COVID-19 infection in India is lesser than in European countries. This may make one wonder what could be the reason for low mortality. Now, scientists from Varanasi-based Banaras Hindu University have identified the genetic basis for the low mortality due to COVID-19 infection in India. In the study, which was published in journal PLOS ONE, scientists show that the variation in the genetic sequence of ACE2 receptors between European ancestry people and Indians is what gives Indian low mortality. ACE2 receptors are bounded by the COVID-19 virus and act as an entry point for the virus in the body. Therefore, variation in the ACE2 region is what decides susceptibility or severity of COVID-19 infection in a person. The scientists studied this ACE2 receptor region in various continental populations and found that certain changes in the region are what giving an edge to the South Asian and East Asian population in fighting COVID-19 virus in a better manner than USA and Europe. Let's hear more on this from our experts.
very specific role to determine our susceptibility against this virus. And there was three more research which came and said that the entry of this virus, there is like the virus entry to the human was due to a gene, and the gene was playing as a role of the gateway. So there is a gateway for this virus to enter into the human body. And we tried to look this gateway into different subcontinent and continents and various kind of human population. So we found out that the gateway of this virus is much more easier to enter into European and Americans. So, and also among the South Asian, the population which is living into Indian subcontinent, they are having very complex type of mutations, which is mostly hindering the entrance of this virus. And the structure of this gateway is very similar to the Southeast Asians as well as the East Asian population. And when we look to the different cases present into various subcontinents, various countries, we found out that our observation was perfectly matching with the various level of infection, various level of death rates into all different countries. So we found out that the Indians, around 60% of the Indians living from east to west, north to south, they are having some unique kind of mutations that is called a haplotype into the genetic terminology. So this haplotype is usually protecting people from being infected to the coronavirus.
That's all for now. You can share your feedback and suggestions to us on the email ID flashing on your screens. And for more such videos, download India Science app or visit our website www.indiascience.in. And do not forget to follow us on social media. We'll be back with another edition of COVID-19 Bulletin soon. Namaskar.